Hi there, see you again in English Simplified channel. In this session we are going to cover experimental research design. This topic is discussed under the subtopics. They are Part A, what, when, why, and how the experimental design is used. Part B, the types of experimental research design, such as pre-experimental research design, quasi-experimental research design, true experimental research design, factorial design. These types of experimental research design will be discussed in detail. Are you ready to rock? Let's get started. Part A. What is experimental research design? When or why is it used? Experiments are used to study causal relationships. You manipulate one or more independent variables and measure their effect on one or more dependent variables. What is meant by causal relationship? Well, correlation describes an association between variables. When one variable changes, so does the other. A correlation is a statistical indicator of the relationship between variables. Variables are normally divided into two types in a research. They are independent and dependent variable. As you can see by the picture, the independent variable is the cause. Its value is independent of other variables in your study, while the dependent variable is the result of the effect. Its value depends on changes in the independent variable. All right. Experimental design means creating a set of procedures to systematically test a hypothesis. A good experimental design requires a strong understanding of the system you are studying. Let's focus on the underlined words that are to test a hypothesis. As you know, a hypothesis is an educated guess about something in the world around you. It should be testable, either by experiment or observation. It means, it is a decision to accept or reject the null hypothesis or alternative hypothesis, in other words, to prove whether there is or there is no significant effect caused by the independent variable to the dependent variable. In which, by testing the hypothesis, then we'll come to conclusion of what variable is accepted or rejected. Now let's see how is experimental research design used or applied. In conducting an experimental research, there are three key steps that you should consider. They are 1. Consider your variables and how they are related. 2. Write a specific testable hypothesis. And 3. Design the experimental. Let's discuss one by one. Step 1. Define your variables. In defining the variables, you should begin with a specific research question. So, what is a research question? A research question is a specific inquiry which the research seeks to provide a response to. It resides at the core of systematic investigation, and it helps you to clearly define a path for the research process. In addition, a research question is usually the first step in any research project. Basically, it is the primary interrogation point of your research, and it sets the pace for your work. So, to conclude, typically, a research question focuses on the research, determines the methodology and hypothesis, and guides all stages of inquiry, analysis, and reporting. With the right research questions, you will be able to gather useful information for your investigation. In order to understand clearly of what research variable is, let's comprehend it by this example of a research question. Does group work discussion affect on the student's speaking skill? The underlined words, group work discussion and the student's speaking skill are termed as independent and dependent variables. Once again, the independent variable is the cause. Its value is independent of other variables in your study. In which, based on the research question, group work discussion is the source of the effect. Furthermore, the dependent variable is the result of the effect. Its value depends on changes in the independent variable. In conclusion, based on the research question above, students' speaking skill is the result or affected by group work discussion. Well, now let's understand the step 2. That is to write your hypothesis. Now that you have a strong conceptual understanding of the system you are studying, you should be able to write a specific testable hypothesis that addresses your research question. What is a hypothesis? A hypothesis is a precise testable statement of what the researchers predict will be the outcome of the study. It is stated at the start of the study. In addition, in research, there is a convention that a hypothesis is written in two forms, the null hypothesis and the alternative hypothesis, called the experimental hypothesis when the method of investigation is an experiment. So, to test a hypothesis, the researcher first assumes that there is no difference between populations from which they are taken. This is known as the null hypothesis. The research hypothesis is often called the alternative hypothesis. Well, let's clarify this by an example. Does group work discussion affect on the student's speaking skill? The alternative hypothesis states that there is a relationship between the two variables being studied. One variable has an effect on the other. So, the alternative hypothesis. There is a significant effect of group work discussion on the student's speaking skill. While the null hypothesis states that there is no relationship between the two variables being studied, one variable does not affect the other. Then, the null hypothesis. There is no significant effect of group work discussion on the student's speaking skill. And now we come up to the step 3. That is, design the experimental. In designing the experimental research, we should consider these points. A. Who is the population and how the sample are taken or selected? B. What is the instrument of data collection? C. How the treatment is applied? D. How the data is analyzed or what statistical analysis is used? E. Report the data or make conclusion. In understanding these points, then we should discuss it in specific. It means, these can be done under what types of experimental that will carry on. So let's discuss and understand them by focusing on to the types of experimental research design, such as pre-experimental research design, quasi-experimental research design, true experimental research design, and factorial design. All right, the discussion of these is made in a separate video tutorial. See you there, and don't forget to support this channel by your subscribe. Thanks and ta-ta.